Salsa .com podcast. My name is Anthony.
And I'm Julie.
And today we're going to show you the cross-bodied 180 from a turn. Now, if this is your first Salsa episode, we suggest that you maybe go back to the basics and learn the basic cross-body lead. For those who are already familiar with that, that's what we're going to show you today, okay? Just as a point of reference, we're going to do a cross-body lead with turn. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1. Okay. Now the difference between doing this and a 180 is that as the girl finishes her turn, okay, you gotta imagine the circle around her, right? She's the center of the circle, and you're gonna go from one side of that circle, follow a curved path, and then the other side, and then finish the cross-body this way, right? So because you're going half a circle around the lady, that's why it's 180 degrees. So that there's no confusion between the 360 and the 180. And we'll teach the 360 some other time after you, I guess, you know, get this down. Okay? So the girl ends here on 7, okay? Because as she's turning 7 before she hits that 1, right? When you're doing this on 1. Now, the only difference that the guy is gonna be doing is that as she's turning, so she's turning, I'm gonna use my hand, I'm gonna place it on her back, okay? Instead of stepping forward on one, I'm gonna step across on one. And if you can imagine, there's this imaginary line going from this side to that side of the wall. Here we have walls. And then a perpendicular line going through that imaginary line and her being the center. You wanna take your left leg and place it on that line that's gonna be intersecting this salsa slot so that you can come around on this side, okay? So as she's turning, I'm gonna take my right hand, put it on her back, or close to the shoulder blade. Take my left leg, step here on 1, then take my right leg, step on this line on 2, and then bring my left leg back on 3, okay? So just review from that, here we go. We go forward on 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, okay? Now, as I finish 3, because, you know, we're really rotating in a circle as I'm picking her up, that's gonna cause multiple forces, centripetal force and a centrifugal force. And at the time that we finish on this 3, because we're generating this force that's coming around, and I open up, we're gonna create this rubber band effect, okay? And this rubber band effect is what you're gonna be taking advantage of, so when we feel that pressure, we can pull her to the other side so that she can finish that crossbar lead, okay? So from here, what you have to make sure is that this hand is on her shoulder blade. If it goes lower, you might tend to lose a lady. So you wanna make sure it's high and it's secure. Usually, I mean, sometimes the higher is better. So there's this nice little bump on the lady's shoulder blade that if you grab it on there and kind of use your forearm to also hold her back, I mean, don't be so forceful, of course, but I'm just giving you like a tip. That'll help her feel more secure when she's gonna be launched out, okay? Now from this, as we're creating this rubber band effect, a good styling mechanism is to either kick your hip out, I mean, not kick your hip out, place your hip out so you feel the rubber band effect even more, and then push her out with your right hand, okay? Now, there's multiple ways to do this move, okay? So that was one way. Now, here's another one. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, okay? Instead of crossing in front, you can cross behind. Now, it's a little bit tougher, but it's really what you prefer. You can come here to do 1, 2, 3, and then do the same part, okay? So doing it fast. Here we go. On 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1. Okay? Now, to give the girls a little bit of tips. Julia has something for you.
For the ladies, we're gonna do arm styling on one and three. For the one, our arm's just gonna come up right here in the center so we don't hit our guy on one. And then at the very end, three is when we have that resistance. We go out on three. Now I'll demonstrate. One, two, three, five, six, seven. One, two, three, five, six, seven.
Okay, we'll do it again. Now regular speed, the whole thing done. Five, six, seven. One, two, three, five, six, seven. One, two, three, five, six, seven, one. Okay. Last thing is that we're gonna do it on two. That's right, for on two, folks, okay? Again, remember, we usually do the intro on two, so for you who are new to our videos, we do the intro on two, we teach the move on one because we know there's more beginners that are dancing on one, and then for as you get more advanced dancing on two, you can use these counts instead. Same move, different counts, okay? Five, six, seven, one, two, three, five, six, seven, one, two, three, five, six, seven, one, two, three, six, seven. Good? Thank you.